From Heritage TV, we are here with one of our royal fathers who has been performing wonderfully well in his community. Can we meet with you, sir?
Yeah, good afternoon. My name is His Majesty Oba Abdulkafar, Olasu Community Jani, the Alawu of Awu, Owu Kingdom.
So, Kabiyesi, sir. It's nice meeting with you.
You're welcome.
You've been a very vibrant Kabiyesi on the social media.
Thank you.
The general belief of the people out there is that royal fathers don't have time for social media. But how come? How do you come about this passion for social media, sir?
I use social media as a kind of relief. Anytime I'm less busy, I go on social media. Instead of doing unnecessary things. That is my own kind of relaxation.
Okay.
I do go on social media anytime I want to relax.
Is that so?
Yeah.
That is very fantastic, sir. So let's come back home, sir. Kabiyesi. Like every royal father, can we start by knowing the community, number one, how the kingdom come about, and so on, sir?
Thank you. Awu was known to be a market. Marketing by about 32 villages. But when development came, everybody now uses these days as a base, as a residential. The proximity of the railway station around here make it easier for everybody to bring their goods from the villages to station.
Okay.
And then there's no vehicle. Everybody had to walk about 5 miles, 6 miles before coming to the railway station. We now decided that let us have a permanent building around here.
Okay.
That is how this place came to be a town.
Fantastic. Now, this place came to be a town. And let's look at the kingdom of Awu, sir.
Yeah, well, Awu is under Awu Kingdom.
Okay.
Under
Awu Kingdom, you
say? Yes, under Awu Kingdom. We have produced 3 Olowus.
Okay.
And you see, though all part of Abeokuta, entirely Egbas, are here.
Okay.
We have Baguras, we have Okeono, we have Ake.
Okay.
But this place we only belong to Owu Kingdom.
Okay.
And we are farmers and hunters.
Okay.
Our people do hunting, we are big time farmers.
Okay.
They are known for cassava, rice, and lot of it.
Okay. So, sir, research and history shows that you were upgraded from the position of a bale to a king. Can you give us an insight to this achievement?
To God be the glory.
Thank you, sir.
I was appointed as a bale by the community, by a footing pattern. And the entire community insisted that they want me as a bale, even though I don't want to be.
Okay.
I tried to run away, but as God will have it, with the help of Almighty God, the Olowu, the chief Ni Adegbenro, our former chairman, Iskilu Makinde, and the entire community,
right.
They made it happen that they insisted they want me.
Okay.
And as God will have it, I was upgraded to a coronet over exactly 9 months. I was made a bale.
Okay.
And after God will have it, I was promoted again to Patu Oba.
Wow.
By the same regime of Otumba Ben Gadani.
Okay.
So that is how I came over.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Kabiyesi, we are here as Heritage TV, the baby of the Ministry of Culture and Tourism of Ogun State, and you are also an active foreign contributor. What can you say about the concept of Heritage TV, which is purely an online TV station?
First of all, I have to give kudos to the governor for his initiative to appoint a person that fits to the seat.
Okay.
As a commissioner.
Okay.
For art and culture. Mm. Because if not for the commissioner, there won't be this what we are doing today.
Okay.
The ministry has been there for years.
Okay.
Nothing of such happened.
Okay.
In the ministry.
Okay.
So I give kudos to the governor.
Okay.
I give kudos to the commissioner.
Okay.
Because I know somebody must have given proposal about this.
Okay.
I can easily dump it and don't do anything about it. So I give kudos to him. I give kudos to the initiator of this project, Because though the person behind the scene can be taking money, but for your sleepless efforts, your because all the time I see you online, at the time I would say, ah, this man don't sleep at all. What happened? So I give kudos to you.
Thank you so much. Sir. Welcome. Now, it's this platform, the Heritage TV, is an online TV station dedicated to the promotion of cultural values and tourist centers. And what do you have for the main custodian of our cultural values, the Royal Fathers like you, sir?
Royal Fathers, we have many things. We need support of government. As in community, as in domain, the poverty level here is very, very high. Everywhere all over the nation, you can see that the poverty level is very high. So
we are having a very nice time with our Royal Father here, who is giving us the background of his kingdom. So Kavis, you are welcome again, sir. So on Heritage TV concept, and as a Royal Father, what advice have you seen Royal Fathers on social media, on Heritage TV?
My advice for my colleagues over. Social media is a good opportunity for you to render your image. Let me give you an example. Some people came here about three or four days ago from the UK. So they want somebody that to promote their solar energy.
Okay.
And they came here, they want this place to be solar energy powered.
Okay.
They want to disengage from government
source of power.
So if there's if I'm not on social media, they will not discover me.
Mm.
So my advice for all Royal Fathers is to try as much as possible. You can link up your secretary to be your PA on social media.
Okay.
You can, any of your children can be your PA on social media.
Mm.
So anybody can do that for you.
Okay.
But as far as I'm concerned, social media is my source of relax.
Okay.
So anytime I want to relax, I go on social media.
Okay. Thank you so much, Sir Kabiesi. You've heard it from the mouth of Kabiesi himself. Our Kabiesi here is one of the vibrant house member on Heritage Social Media Forum on Twitter. And I'm quite sure that by the time we launch the Facebook and the YouTube part of it, he'll be willing to be one of our administrators there. Am I correct?
Or are very correct.
So thank you so much, sir. Now, Kabiesi, let's come to your kingdom. We want you to talk about, give us an insight to the communities that made up this kingdom and some of government projects around this, your environment, sir.
I want to give thanks to the governor. He gave us a settlement, farm settlement, that houses almost about 200 or 100 houses.
Okay.
And he gave us a model school. But my concern about the school, I'm pleading to him to turn the secondary school to higher station for us.
Okay.
We need at least a polytechnic.
Okay.
And in his own good will, he was here all the time to see how we can improve more on it. The last 4 years was focused on urban development.
Okay.
I want him to come back a bit to rural development too, so that we can get benefit of government.
Thank you so much.
On the people that comprise this kingdom, I have 32 villages.
Wow.
I will have another urban within our community. Yes, that is the person of the Wulade of Akinyale.
Okay.
And I have many valleys around. Okay. You have many prominent citizens of this community.
Okay.
You have the Amosu, the Adegbin Rose,
okay,
the Lopade, many Yamakinde, many of them.
Okay.
And from here, so we are on guard.
Thank you, Sir Kabiesi. Now let us pick you from your activities.
Right.
You saw so many pictures of your activities, like the less privileged projects, like you traveled abroad, you took pictures with some, foreign nationals. Can you tell us the reason or the objective and what you intend to achieve from this?
Well, all my travel all over the world is about our development. How to develop my community.
Okay.
I met with American Ambassador.
Mm-hmm.
I met Minister of Agriculture of Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
I met with Minister of Canada, Ambassador of Canada.
Okay.
I met with a lot of people.
Okay.
Many people came here from abroad.
Okay.
All because I want development.
Okay.
I have many things in pipeline for development.
Wow.
I have tomato and rice plantation and processing
wow.
on ground. I have our film city. I have many things. About the left to village, I look at homes. I will seek your indulgence one day.
Okay.
You have to visit the home.
Okay.
See, you see where in 36 years of age cannot walk.
Mm-hmm.
All his life, lie down all his life. You see many things here. So I want to plead to the government, to the world,
to NGOs,
to assist us. That's what prompted me to give them an acre of land here. One of you just visit there and start doing something there.
Okay.
I've committed 10% of my salary to the development of the project. This community has potentials to grow,
wow.
to develop.
And we have welcome visitors.
We have large land for any investor to come.
Mm-hmm.
We have land, we have railway line, we have railway station,
mm-hmm.
we have gas line, we have dam, and we have electricity.
Wow.
So anything you want in terms of investment or in terms of production is available.
And just about 5 minutes drive to the capital.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes. So you are like in Abeokuta anyway.
You are just like you are in Abeokuta.
Yes.
So thank you so much, Kabiyesi. Talking about some of the projects that you have on the pipeline, are there any hindrances or challenges, you know, around the implementation?
I have challenges.
Okay.
I have challenges. Like I rightly said, that some people came here for solar power. I thought instead of putting the solar something in my balance,
okay.
I decided that let us put it in settlements.
Okay.
So in our settlements, government have done what they can do to put up structure, good structure, give the farmers land, give them all the assistance. But there's no light there.
Wow.
So I now decided let me go and put this solar thing to that place. Then I call one of the director in the Ogadep, because Ogadep are managing the something. So to inform him that I'm taking some people to go and inspect the place. And with good heart, he accepted. But about 10 minutes thereafter, the most senior director there called me that I should not go, that I should seek permission of the commissioner before I visit the place. But I ignore him. I ignore her because this thing is on my domain and it's for the benefit of the people and my domain. So I have to go ahead and show the place. After all, we are not taking anything away from there.
Just for sightseeing.
It's for sightseeing. So I don't know why she said I should not go for God's sake. So I have to go. I ignore her and go to that settlement to show the people this is where I want the solar energy to be put in place. So, and in terms of our film city, I believe Governor will give us all the maximum support. We are here to meet him. We are doing some little things to meet him. We approach him and tell him what we have in our mind, what is in the pipeline.
Okay. So when you say film city, we have so many cities. Can you tell us, share with us the objective of that
yes,
city?
Yes, the objective of film city. Our film city is where you can come as an artist to do total packaging.
Wow.
Anything you are thinking of. In making films. It's a place you can come for relaxation.
Wow.
We have gardens where you can take your children to come and for holidays.
Okay.
We have hotels where you can relax, come in and relax.
Okay.
We have artificial dam where you can dam and do fishing.
On the master plan.
On the master plan.
Okay.
We have many things there. We are going to put it on the 500 acres of land.
Wow.
So it's a total package. It's a place you can think of anywhere in the world. So where can I go to go and relax? Let me go to our room. So it's only what we need is government support.
Wow.
I believe when we get to the we need the governor, especially the commissioner for art and tourism, because it's part of tourism.
Yes, part
so,
of tourism.
So we are still coming to them.
Thank you so much, sir. I pray that God Almighty will assist you in all these endeavors, sir.
Amen.
So Kabiyesi, talk about festivals.
Yeah.
We've heard about Disabi Festival, Ojudioba Festival, and Akarigbo, so many other festivals. Is there any festival that brings the people, the leaders of this community, back home from time to time?
We have many.
Wow.
First and foremost, we have Yam Festival.
Wow.
which we always do first Sunday on October. Okay. We have the Ifa Festival.
Okay.
On the 19th of April.
Okay.
We have Alarabu Festival.
Okay.
On the 19th of August.
Wow.
Then we have a religious festival.
Okay.
That is Christmas, okay. Ileya, okay. Itunawe. And I also organize crusade, Christian crusade. Yes, I organize places, 3 hours places for God.
As a Muslim?
As a, as a Muslim, but in a Christian way.
In the Christian way?
Yes.
That's very fantastic.
I organize Tajud as a Muslim.
Okay.
So many activities go on throughout the year.
And you enjoy it, sir?
I do enjoy it.
Thank
you so much. Because you can see that it's only with God. With a lot of prayer, you can do anything.
Yes.
Without prayer, you cannot do anything. It's not all about food or whatever. It's all about God.
It's all about God.
Yes. Even in festival, I praise God.
Yes.
If I do anything, it's God. It's just up to God.
And
my God with him.
So thank you so much, sir. You've heard from the KBAC what he has been doing offline, which we know is going to go online too. Now, KBAC, let's visit your private life. Are you a businessman? What do you do? The people want to know out there.
I'm a businessman.
Wow.
I'm into construction.
Construction.
I'm into properties. All my life I've been doing properties.
Okay.
Before I became an lover, I'm a property man.
Okay.
I don't sell land anyway.
Okay.
I do sell, buy houses, resell.
Okay.
I buy house, renovate and sell.
Okay.
I build complex and sell.
Okay.
I'm a developer.
Okay.
That is all I do. I do all my life I've been doing properties.
Okay. But research shown that you are also passionate into agricultural implements.
Agricultural implements is because of my domain.
Wow.
It's because I'm here.
Okay.
I sit down here idle. I don't want to be idle.
Okay.
And I want to see how I can improve my people.
Okay.
The poverty level here is very high.
Yeah.
My people are doing farming. They are not making any profits. They don't know they are not making profits. Because a farmer, his wife, his children, everybody will go into farming. At the end of harvesting time, maybe they work for about 3 months. Let's take that for example. Maybe you want to do maize. And you plant maize, you clear maize, ground, do everything before you harvest.
Yeah.
At the end of the 3 months, maybe you make about
150,000.
Hmm. The entire family. Are they making profit? They are not making profit because they don't reduce the human labor.
Hmm.
That is why I came up with the issue of minor tractor.
Okay.
So if as a community, about 5 or 6 people can gather together and buy one.
Mm.
We arrange a bank that can give them loan,
yes,
for that, so that it will make it easier for them.
Mm.
That in that, their children will go to school,
okay,
the wife will go to market and do other things.
Yes.
It's him alone that will supervise the tractor.
Yes.
That the tractor is working. What they will do in 10 days, the tractor will do it in a
day
for them. And it will give them relax.
Mm.
You see, if you see any farmer of my age, he will look like in 90 years or 100 years of age.
Mm.
And we are of the same age. And it's because they are farming, they are using human labor to farm. So I want government to encourage us more about farming. I want government to assist our people. We don't want them to die like that, without having nothing. You see, what they can achieve is maybe they are able to sponsor their children to school
and
feed themselves. That's all. Some of them cannot even feed themselves. I see a lot of things here. Many people will come to the palace. Some people are supposed to go to the chairman office or go to the government. They will not go there, they come to the cover of us. We are the immediate people they can see at any time. At the middle of that, they will come and knock at your door. Can't they see my son is sick? Can't they see my wife is sick? They want money from you. How much is our salary? No security food, nothing. So they should do more. Government should try to do more. Though our governor is trying his best, but government's best is not enough in regards to others. What they are giving to others is not only in the Ogun State. It's happened all over the places.
Mm.
Because we about go all over the places to interact with ourselves.
Okay.
We discuss our problem.
Okay.
And it's the same problem everywhere.
Mm.
It is only Lagos State that is a little bit better.
Okay.
Maybe because of their own idea that is increasing every day.
Okay.
I still understand. And I believe after Lagos State is Ogun State.
Mm.
So we should be able to improve on our living.
The
standard of living is not even good. You will see some people cannot afford to buy a car.
Mm.
It's very ridiculous.
Yes.
Some of us cannot buy a car.
Mm.
Some of us, it is our children that will say, okay, daddy, you cannot be a car, and be going like this. if you get another person, some cabbies, you see their palace, you know, how can I see in such a place? Mm. And there's nothing you can do. You don't want to spell our name. Mm. So the only thing government can do for us is to assist us.
Wow, that is very wonderful. That's very exciting. If you are watching from any part of the world, you can see that you have, you know, a friend here as a KBC when it comes to relationship, when it comes to networking, when it comes to, you know, accommodating investors. You have a friend. So if you really want to get in touch with a KBC, you can Google him. His name is all over, you know, the whole place, and you can also have his contact. He's very close to the people there here. And this community is just about less than 5 minutes drive to the main capital city of